Hi, I'm Matt from eSpares. In this video, I'll be helping you to find out why your fridge freezer is making strange noises. There are a number of reasons why this might be happening, and different noises indicate different issues. In this video, we'll help you to identify and get to the bottom of the problem and help you fix the fault yourself. To complete these checks, you will need a flathead screwdriver and a Phillips head screwdriver. The first thing to check are the fans. Now, depending on your model number, you may have two or three fans on your fridge freezer. These are evaporator fans that are usually found inside the freezer compartment. And on this model, an evaporator fan that's located in the fridge compartment, and a condenser fan, which is located at the back of the appliance. A great way to check if the evaporator fan is the problem is to open and close the fridge and freezer doors. If the noise stops when the door is open, then the problem is with the evaporator fan. Also, if there is a ticking or grinding noise, again, that indicates a problem with the evaporator fan. If, however, the noise persists when the door is open, then your problem lies with the condenser fan at the back of the appliance. Now, I'm going to show you how to replace the evaporator fan in the fridge compartment. The process for the evaporator fan in the freezer compartment is very similar. The first thing you need to do is to remove the contents of your fridge, as well as any shelves or drawers. Next, we need to remove the evaporator cover. Before we do that, just check that there's no ice in the screw holes or in the vent, because if there is, it could mean there's ice behind the cover and you will not be able to remove the cover without damaging it. So leave it to defrost for around 48 hours and try again. And it's a good idea to place a towel at the base of the fridge to soak up any water during this process. If you don't see any ice, you can go ahead and remove the cover. First, release the two clips from the top by prising them away with a flathead screwdriver. Then remove the two screws at the top of the cover and the two at the bottom, and also the two screws that hold the tank in place, because you need to remove that as well. You can now pull the evaporator fan cover towards you. There are electrical connections holding it in place at the top here, so just disconnect those and then you can lift the evaporator fan cover out of the way. To get the fan cover off, you need to roll back the foil at the bottom and also the adhesive tape at the top that is holding the wires in. Now, to remove the fan cover, remove the four screws and unclip the wiring. To remove the fan, undo the three screws that hold it in place and pull it away. Fit the evaporator fan into the place of the old one and refit the screws. You can then refit the fan cover. And then reclip in the wiring and reposition the tape at the top and the bottom. You can then place the evaporator cover into position, refit the electrical connections, then refit the screws, two at the top, two at the bottom, and also the two that hold the tank in place. You can then fit the covers at the top, making sure they click into place. Then replace any drawers and shelves, and of course, food and drink. If you've checked your evaporator fans and they're fine, and the noise persisted after you opened the doors in the test earlier, then the problem lies with the condenser fan. The condenser fan compresses heat to keep the condenser coils cool, and it can be found at the rear of the fridge at the bottom here. On some models, there will be a cover covering the bottom part of the rear of the fridge. If you have that on your model, simply undo the screws to access the condenser fan here. The next thing we need to do is to undo these two screws at the bottom of the condenser fan. Then unplug the electrical connection. Now, once the screws and the electrical connection are removed, there is a knack to removing the condenser fan itself. Throughout the process, be very careful of this gas pipe here, as it's very hard to replace. So you have to push forward to release clips, then back, and then gently turn it over to the left-hand side, and then slowly moving that pipe out of the way, you can then ease the condenser fan out itself, being very careful. For reference, these are the clips at the bottom of the condenser fan, and these clip into the base at the bottom of the fridge. To fit your new condenser fan, simply reverse the removal process, putting it in at an angle. Gently move that gas pipe out the way. And then it's a case of straightening the condenser fan up and making sure the clips fit in place. Pushing it so it locks in to the base. Once the condenser fan's in place, reconnect the electrical connection and screw it into place. Whilst you're checking for where noises are coming from in your fridge freezer, it's a good idea to check for safety issues too. Check out our video here, which takes you through some important safety checks that you yourself can carry out on your fridge freezer. If you have a water dispenser or ice maker on your fridge freezer, then the noise could be caused by a faulty inlet valve. Now, if you hear a humming noise and there's no water coming from the water dispenser or no ice coming from the ice maker, then this could indeed be the problem. To check this, the best thing to do is to unplug the water inlet pipe from the fridge freezer and put it into a bucket. If the water flow is good, then the problem is the valve itself. However, if there is no water flow, then of course the problem is with the water supply to the fridge freezer. To remove the inlet valve, take out the left-hand screw here using your Phillips head screwdriver. Remove the wiring at the top. Then remove the two black clips from the valve collar and then push the collar up to release the hose. To fit the new valve, push the hoses into the collars of the valve and then refit the black clips. You can then screw it to the rear of the appliance and reconnect the electrical connection. The final thing to check for noises in your fridge freezer is the compressor. Now, the best way to test this is to put your hand on top of the compressor. If it's warm and vibrating, that means it's fine. However, if it's rattling and hot, then there is a problem with the compressor. But it's best to get a professional to help you with this fix. We hope this video has been helpful in helping you diagnose and fix that unwanted fridge freezer noise. But remember, not all appliance noises are bad. Sometimes they can be relaxing, help you to concentrate, and even help you sleep. So check out our appliance white noise playlist down here to see if it can help you. And remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel for further tips and advice on diagnosing, fixing, and maintaining your household and garden appliances. Thanks for watching.